What Tridrid was just a big surprise to us, you know. It took us into the mainstream, and we never thought we'd be there.
Tri was a big enough hit that one might expect the lads to be recording their second album in an expensive, top-of-the-line recording studio, with sushi and a massage just a finger snap away. Instead, they're recording here in rather makeshift surroundings in an obscure part of Toronto where musicians seldom tread. Why? Because it feels like home.
Bad enough notes for you, Ike?
Mungo plays the...
It's actually a little colder than home, but this cave-like former theater has the sound they're looking for and an unintimidating atmosphere that encourages improvisation. The chairs are from home, the sound baffles are old sleeping bags. Glamorous it isn't, but from this they figure great music will come.
Well, a studio is built to absorb sound, and so that you don't have sound bouncing off the walls. But it sort of has the same effect on an individual. It sort of draws the energy out of it. They're very dead places. They're like waiting rooms in offices or something like that. You know, they're just... And I think that for some bands and people, I'm sure they're fantastic things, but for us, we just sort of would watch TV a lot. You know, it's your time to do your part, and you'd go.
You go
do your part.
But do you think that this will create a better record for you?
I think that it creates a better atmosphere to perform in, and I think that will hopefully result in a better record. We're thinking of performing like this from now on, just setting up in chairs and letting people wander through and hear what instrument they want.
Families are already important parts of their lives, and business often mixes with pleasure, as it did for Cuddy's 33rd birthday. If another hit like Try pops out of their second album, their lives will be radically different before Cuddy turns 34.
Obviously, there's going to be some jabs taken at us just because we have a country name and because people who haven't seen us think we're country music. And so, yeah, it's a bit frightening, but as long as we kind of stick to our grassroots, you know, we're really a club band that kind of grew out of clubs. And as long as we stick to that, we feel comfortable. So we'll see what happens beyond that.